In my town, Halloween was celebrated with a huge festival every year. People would decorate their houses, dress up, and carve jack-o'-lanterns to place on their porches. But there was one tradition everyone followed without question: the jack-o'-lantern rule. Never leave your jack-o'-lantern unlit on Halloween night. The rule had been around for as long as anyone could remember, and no one really knew where it came from. But everyone followed it, no matter what. Some people said that if you left your jack-o'-lantern unlit on Halloween night, you'd invite something unwelcome into your home. Most people brushed it off as just an old superstition, but no one dared to test it. One Halloween, my friend Oliver and I were out trick-or-treating, getting as much candy as we could before the festival started. We got to Oliver's house. We noticed his jack-o'-lantern was sitting on the porch, its grin wide and sinister, but the candle inside had burned out. "Hey, aren't you supposed to keep that lit?" I asked, nudging him. Oliver shrugged, laughing. "It's just an old story. Nothing's gonna happen." He took out his lighter, but then paused, smirking. "Actually, why don't we see what happens?" I didn't like the idea. My parents had always warned me about the jack-o'-lantern rule, and even though I didn't believe in curses, something about the rules stuck with me. But Oliver was stubborn, and before I could say anything, he left the jack-o'-lantern dark and walked inside to drop off his candy. As we walked to the festival, I couldn't shake the feeling that we'd made a mistake. The festival was lively, with music, games, and stalls lined with orange and black decorations. We had a great time, but as the night went on, I kept catching glimpses of something out of the corner of my eye. A dark figure, just barely visible in the crowd, watching us. Every time I looked, it was gone, but the uneasy feeling lingered. "Did you see that?" I whispered to Oliver, glancing over my shoulder. "See what?" he asked, distracted by a candy apple stall. I shook my head, telling myself it was nothing. But as we made our way home after the festival, I couldn't shake the feeling that we were being followed. When we reached Oliver's house, I glanced at the darkened jack-o'-lantern on his porch. Its carved grin seemed wider now, its eyes darker, deeper. Oliver laughed it off, making fun of me for being jumpy, and went inside. I walked home, but the feeling of being watched stayed with me the entire way. That night, just as I was about to drift off to sleep, my phone buzzed. It was a text from Oliver. "You're not going to believe this. My jack-o'-lantern is back on, but I never relit it." I sat up, my heart pounding. I texted back, asking if he was messing with me. He replied with a picture. The jack-o'-lantern was sitting on his porch, its eyes and mouth glowing with an eerie, flickering light. But what unsettled me most was the shadow in the background of the picture. A tall, thin figure standing just behind the jack-o'-lantern, its face obscured, watching from the darkness. I tried calling him, but it went straight to voicemail. I texted him again, asking if he was okay, but there was no response. The next day, Oliver wasn't at school. I tried calling him, texting him, even stopping by his house, but no one answered the door. His parents were out of town, and it seemed like he'd just vanished. The only sign he'd been there was the jack-o'-lantern on his porch, still lit, still grinning that sinister grin. The police got involved, and the whole town was asking about his disappearance. Some people thought he'd run away, others thought it was some kind of prank, but I knew the truth. I remember the shadow in the photo, the feeling of being watched, the unlit jack-o'-lantern on his porch. A few nights later, I was lying in bed when I heard the faint scratching of sound outside my window. I froze, listening, my heart pounding. The scratching grew louder, more insistent, like someone or something was dragging sharp nails across the glass. Slowly, I turned to look, and there, on the other side of the window, was Oliver's jack-o'-lantern, its eyes and mouth flickering with a ghostly light. And standing beside it was the shadowy figure. Tall and thin, its face twisted into a grin that matched the jack-o'-lantern's. I tried to scream, but no sound came out. The figure raised a long, bony finger and tapped the glass, its grin widening, its hollow eyes locked onto mine. The next morning, the jack-o'-lantern was gone. No one believed me when I told them about the shadow, about the jack-o'-lantern that had appeared at my window. But every Halloween since, as midnight approaches, I find a small pumpkin on my porch, uncarved, with a single candle beside it, and I know what it means. Every Halloween, I light the candle, place it in the pumpkin, and make sure it stays burning all night. I'm too afraid to find out what happens if it goes out.